President, please be seated.
President, veuillez vous asseoir.
The court
is back in session.
Reprise des débats.
On internal rule 91 bis of the ECCC,
the chamber gives the floor to
the co-prosecutors to put questions to the witness Prum Sarun before other parties. The combined time for co-prosecutors and colleague lawyers is two sessions. You may now proceed.
Good afternoon, Mr. President, Your Honours, everyone in and around the courtroom.
My name is Song Chowon. I am the Deputy Co-Prosecutor of the National Side. I will have several questions this afternoon to ask you.
I want to start first with the 17 April 1975. On that particular day, where did you leave and what did you do? Answer. I lived in Phnom Sompo commune, Banan district, Battambang province. Question. What was your occupation then?
Quelle était votre profession à cette époque?
President, please observe the microphone before you speak, Mr. Witness.
Monsieur le témoin, regardez votre microphone avant de parler.
Witness, I was simply chief of
j'étais tout simplement chef
a platoon.
Deux sections.
Question. Phnom Sompo commune, Banan district.
Phnom Sompo concerning this commune and district,
what
district
sector was it in?
Dans quel secteur se trouvait-il?
Answer, it was in sector 3.
Dans le secteur 3.
It was said that it was within Sector 3 back then.
Dans le secteur 3 à l'époque.
Question. What was the zone?
Question. Mais quelle était la zone?
President, once again, please observe the microphone, Mr.
President,
Witness.
Monsieur le témoin, à nouveau, veuillez attendre que le microphone soit allumé.
Answer. Réponse. It was within the northwest zone.
C'était dans la zone northwest.
Co-prosecutor, thank you. A while ago,
je vous remercie.
You stated that after
17 April 1975,
you were assigned to be chief of a platoon.
Vous a désigné chef de section.
Do you recall
vous souvenez-vous
under which company and battalion was your
platoon et compagnie votre section était rattachée?
Answer, it was
réponse
under company number 1
c'était rattaché à la compagnie numéro 1
Kropojung village,
Phnom Sompo sub-district.
At that time, I was appointed to be chief of a platoon, and I was responsible for some tasks. Question. Do you recall the name of your immediate supervisor at that time, and what was his real function?
Quelle était sa fonction réelle?
Answer, it was Ta Hong. Ta Hong was the chief of a company within
Kolopojung
village.
Dans le cadre du village de Kolopojung.
Question. Do you recall company Tahong was the chief of?
Et vous souvenez-vous what number de quelle of compagnie Taiching était responsable?
Answer, it was a company number one.
Réponse, c'était la compagnie numéro 1.
Co-prosecutor, Mr. Witness,
Monsieur le témoin.
I would like to clarify some points with you in relation to the statements you provided to the investigators of the OCIJ in document E3/5187, Khmer Yuan 00/19/79/16, Eon in English 00/27/41/77, and French 00/27/41/84. You were interviewed by the investigator of the OCIJ at your village. You stated that you were within battalion number 1 in company number 4, whose chairman was Ta Hong.
Du 4e régiment dirigé par le grand-père Hong.
Do you still stand by your statement you provided to the investigator?
Aux enquêteurs.
And can you tell the court once again what battalion were you in at that time and which company were you in?
À quelle compagnie vous étiez rattaché à l'époque?
Answer. I was under company number 4, battalion number 1.
Numéro 4, bataillon numéro 1.
Co-prosecutor, thank you.
Je vous remercie.
Concerning battalion number 1.
Ce qui concerne le bataillon numéro 1.
Did battalion number 1 belong to the sector or the zone?
Le bataillon numéro 1 appartenait-il au secteur ou à la zone?
President.
Président.
Mr. Witness, please look at the microphone
regardez
before you speak. You
can
now give your answer.
Maintenant, vous pouvez répondre.
Answer.
Réponse.
It did not belong to any sector.
Ça n'appartenait à aucun secteur.
In fact, it belonged to the district.
Ça appartenait au district.
Question. You stated that Ta Hong was the chairman of company number 4, and can you tell the court who was the chairman of battalion number 1?
Était le président du bataillon numéro 1.
Answer. It was Ta Kroy.
Réponse, c'était Ta Kroy.
Co-prosecutor, thank you.
Co-procureur, je vous remercie.
Mr. Witness, I am now moving to a new topic.
Monsieur le témoin, je vais à présent aborder un nouveau
about
sujet.
What happened within your sector, particularly in relation to the Vietnamese. I would like you to tell the court what happened to the Vietnamese within your battalion number 1, and can you tell the court what happened to the Vietnamese within other battalions or companies in the sector? There were Vietnamese.
Réponse, il y avait des Vietnamiens.
And they were killed at Tu Ta Trong. This is what I can tell you and can recall.
Et ce dont je me souviens.
With the Vietnamese were called into a meeting and they were killed at
Tu
Ta Trong near Phnom Koi
or
Koi Mountain.
La montagne Koi.
Co-prosecutor, I will pose some further questions in relation to that matter. But first, I would like to know about your chairman, that is Ta Kroy.
Did Ta Kroy ever
search for the identities of the Vietnamese.
Chercher à déterminer l'identité des Vietnamiens.
No Vietnamese within my, there were no Vietnamese within my battalion. However, there were Vietnamese within other battalions, and those Vietnamese were killed and smashed.
Co-prosecutor,
Mr. Witness, I want to ask you about Ta Groch, who was the leader of battalion number one. I want to know whether or not he used to asked and searched for the Vietnamese.
A chercher les Vietnamiens.
Answer, no. He never searched for the Vietnamese. The battalion number two ever searched for the Vietnamese. As I said, there were no Vietnamese within my unit, said
les
the witness.
Comme je l'ai dit, il n'y avait pas de Vietnamiens dans mon unité.
Question. You have just made a mention that
question.
There were no Vietnamese within your units.
Dans votre unité.
Which units which consisted of the Vietnamese?
Alors, dans quelle unité y avait-il des Vietnamiens?
There were a lot of Vietnamese.
Il y avait
in the battalion number two, as for my battalion, that is battalion number one,
et
there were some
bataillon,
Chinese.
Un, il y avait quelques Chinois.
Co-prosecutor, thank you, Mr. Witness.
Merci.
In the
Monsieur
same
témoin.
Document that you provided your information to the investigator at your village, document
E3/5187,
in the same EON that I read to you earlier, you told the investigator or TERS that in 1976, the Khmer Rouge were searching for the Vietnamese.
Croce,
who was leader of battalion number one, asked me whether or not there were Vietnamese within my unit.
If
so, please report them to me so that I can send them to the upper echelon to handle.
Please,
translation. I want to know about this point, Mr. Witness.
J'aimerais en savoir davantage à ce propos, Monsieur.
Where did Croce ask you about the Vietnamese? Where's about?
Où vous a-t-il demandé? Dans quelles circonstances vous a-t-il demandé où se trouvaient les Vietnamiens?
He asked me about the Vietnamese.
Réponse.
At the place where we grind the rice.
Il m'a posé ces questions au sujet des Vietnamiens à l'endroit où l'on
where we ground the rice. And as I said earlier, there were only Chinese within my unit.
Dans mon unité, il n'y avait
at
que
that
des
time,
Chinois.
Were there anyone?
Question.
Was there anyone
époque,
with you?
Y avait-il
when he asked you about the Vietnamese, what circumstances?
Were they
when you were asked about the Vietnamese?
Est-ce que cet événement a eu lieu?
Answer. At that time, he came to ask me about the Vietnamese. There was only me and him at that time. And I reported to him that there were no Yuan within my unit, but Chinese. Co-prosecutor, thank you.
Merci.
When leader of battalion Croce told you that if there were Vietnamese, you had to report to him so that he can further send information to the upper echelon. Did
Croce
tell you who specifically who was specifically the upper echelon?
Spécifiquement était cet échelon supérieur.
answer. It was the regiment leader that was the upper echelon.
L'échelon supérieur.
Question. A while ago, you stated that Croja was leader of the battalion.
Était le chef du bataillon.
Witness.
Témoin.
Yes, you are right.
Vous avez raison.
And the upper echelon referred to Ta Cham.
Et l'échelon supérieur faisait référence à Ta Cham.
Co-prosecutor, can you be clear on that point?
Être plus clair?
Who was the upper echelon?
Qui
can you tell the names of those who was in the upper echelon level?
Qui était à l'échelon supérieur?
Answer.
Réponse.
It was Ta Cham who was the chief of the district.
Du district.
Thank you. Ta Croix also stated that, quote, send them to upper echelon to handle. What did he mean by stating the word handle?
Qu'est-ce que vous voulez dire exactement par pour action?
Answer. That meant they had to be killed.
Ça voulait dire qu'ils devaient être tués.
The word handle meant kill.
Le terme pour action, cela voulait dire tuer.
Thank you, co-prosecutor. When Ta Croix came to talk to you about whether or not there were Yun within your unit,
s'il y avait ou non des Yun dans votre unité,
did he tell you how to identify the Vietnamese or Yun at that time?
Ou les Yun à l'époque?
Answer. Ta Croix did not ask anything specifically, but he asked whether or not there were Yuan within
mais
my unit, and I told him that in my unit there were Chinese,
il y avait
not
Chinois,
Yuan.
Mais pas de Yuan.
Co-prosecutor, thank you. You have just stated
merci.
That there were no Yuan within your unit or battalion, but to you there were Yuan within battalion number
mais
two. Where did those Yuan come from? President, please hold on and observe microphone, Mr. Witness.
Président, monsieur le témoin, veuillez attendre que le microphone soit
actually, a battalion a number one
témoin,
and number
en fait,
two was stationed next to each other.
L'un à côté de l'autre.
Co-prosecutor, do you recall the names of the commune
vous
and
des noms des
villages which those battalions were stationed in?
Où étaient postés les bataillons?
Answer. There were two battalions within the Kropel Kangcheung village, battalion number one and two.
Bataillon numéro 1 et numéro 2.
Co-prosecutor, were there any other battalions, for example, battalion number 3 and battalion number 4? Answer. There were two other battalions within Bong Khmum. That is battalion number one and battalion number two. And it was under other village responsibility. And I knew only what happened within my village. Co-prosecutor, thank you.
Co-procureur, merci.
After Dacroix, who was chairman of battalion number 1, came to ask you whether or not there were Vietnamese within your battalion.
S'il y avait ou non des Vietnamiens dans votre bataillon.
Did you ever witness the arrest of those Vietnamese within your battalion or within the sector?
Dans votre bataillon ou au sein du secteur?
Answer. Yuan was arrested within the battalion number 2 and they were sent to the upper echelon and I did not know where they were sent to. I only noticed that they disappeared. Co-prosecutor, you stated that the arrest happened within the battalion number 2. How many people were arrested out of that battalion number 2?
Au sein de ce bataillon numéro 2.
Answer. Two of them.
Réponse, deux.
Two people had been arrested and sent away. I did not know where they went.
Je ne sais pas où ils sont allés.
Co-prosecutor, Mr. Witness, in your statement that you gave to the investigator at your village, in the same year and page number, you stated, you told the investigator that Croce, who was a leader of battalion number 1, came to ask me, are there any UN in your unit? If there are, report them to me so that they can be sent to upper echelon to handle. There were no UN in my battalion, but battalion number 2 did have about 20 UN. I saw them arrest the UN and their arms were tied behind their backs, and later on they were walked away to be killed at Tuol Ta
Trong near Phnom Koi.
You, a while ago, made mention that there were only two Yuan arrested within battalion number 2. However, in your statement, you said there were about 20 Yuan. So now, can you clarify this point to the court? How many Yuan were arrested from battalion number 2? Answer, it happened a long time ago. I forget almost all of them.
J'ai presque tout oublié.
Co-prosecutor, fine, Mr. Witness. I may come back to ask you once again about this point. When you saw that the Vietnamese had been arrested, where did you see the arrest?
Où avez-vous vu
l'arrestation? Which location did you see the arrest? Answer. Since the battalions were stationed close to one another, I noticed that that two Yuan were arrested and sent to Tuol Ta Trong near Phnom Koi. It was to the west of my village. It was in a far distance compared to my village. Co-prosecutor, let me go a little bit further into this point.
Permettez que j'approfondisse.
Where exactly did you witness the arrests?
Où avez-vous été témoin de l'arrestation?
Answer, the arrests took place within my village.
Dans mon village.
It happened within battalion number 2.
C'était
in the area of my village.
Dans les parages de mon village.
Co-prosecutor, thank you. Do you know who was the one arresting the two Yuan?
La personne qui a procédé à l'arrestation des deux Yuan.
Answer. It was the children of Khmer Rouge cadres. They were quite young.
Question.
Do you recall how many of those young children coming to address the UN?
Vous souvenez-vous combien ils étaient? Combien de ces jeunes enfants sont venus arrêter les UN?
Answer: four of them
Réponse
came to
quatre.
Arrest
quatre
the
sont
UN.
Venus arrêter les
no
UN.
One
Personne
dares to
n'a osé
protest
protester
their activities.
Contre ces activités.
Co-prosecutor, could you tell the court the process of the arrest? What happened first and what happened next, and where were the UN placed? They were arrested and walked to the westward to the killing sites. The killing site was a termite mound.
Le site d'exécution était une termitière.
Co-prosecutor.
Co-procureur.
Concerning the children of the Khmer Rouge cadre who came to arrest the UN, did they have arms with them?
Est-ce qu'ils étaient armés?
Answer: yes, they had weapons and
ils avaient des armes.
They carried rifles.
Ils portaient des fusils.
Co-prosecutor. Were those arrested by the young children tied? Tied up? Or were they allowed to walk freely? Answer: their hands were tied to their backs.
Ils avaient les mains attachées, leurs mains ont été attachées dans le dos.
Were they tied in a string?
Réponse: étaient-ils en fil?
Were they tied together or individually? Answer: they were tied individually.
Réponse: ils étaient attachés individuellement.
And two young cadres walked one arrested person.
Et deux jeunes cadres
questioned
what
kind of clothes did they use to tie those people?
Type de
it was
scarf
pour
attacher ces
which
personnes.
Was used to tie
Réponse,
those people.
Qui a été utilisée pour attacher ces personnes.
Question. When they were walked away, you have just said that they were walked westward. Where were these arrested people placed in?
Où a-t-on emmené ces personnes? Où les a-t-on placées?
Answer.
Réponse.
I saw the scalps remaining at Tul Ta Trong, and I think they may have been brought to that place, Tul Ta Trong. Question: you stated that these people were sent to Tul Ta Trong near Phnom Koi. Where was it exactly? Which village and commune was it in?
Answer: it was located in the same commune where my village was. And it was to the west of the battalion.
West de là où était posté le bataillon.
And it was near Koi Mountain.
C'était près de Phnom Koi.
Question. So Tul Ta Trong was in the same village and commune where your battalion was based. Is that correct?
Yes, exact.
They were walked for about 3 kilometers.
On les a fait marcher sur une distance de 3 km environ.
And then they were killed there.
Et c'est là qu'ils ont été tués.
Question.
Witness,
I'd like to clarify with you.
Monsieur le témoin.
Regarding this point, you said the children coming to arrest the two Vietnamese and walked them away. And you said that those children were the children of cadres.
Ces enfants étaient les enfants de cadres.
Were the children soldiers or were they in a mobile unit?
Ou étaient-ils au sein
d'une unité
mobile? And
where did they come from?
Et d'où venaient-ils?
And so they were the children of the soldiers at the Copper Mountain.
J'ai dit que c'était les enfants des soldats de la montagne
de Copper.
They belonged
to the cadres in the committee.
C'était les enfants des cadres dans les comités.
Tarak
était responsable de la commune
near Copper Mountain,
près de la montagne Copper,
near the main road.
Près de la route principale.
Question. You told the chamber that the people were walked away and that you saw skulls there. And you said the two Vietnamese were from
battalion number 2.
And how do you know that the two people who were walked away were Yuan from battalion number 2?
Que ces deux personnes qui ont été emmenées étaient des Yuan du bataillon numéro 2.
I heard people said about the skeleton remains at
Tultatrang
because those people were walked there and killed.
Car ces gens ont été emmenés jusque là et ont été tués.
Because once they were walked away, that would be the end of
quand
their life.
Quand ils étaient emmenés, ça signifiait la fin
question.
De leur vie.
My question is this.
Non, ma question
you mentioned
suivante.
That the people who were walked away were
Yuan or Vietnamese.
And how did you know that they were Vietnamese?
Saviez-vous qu'ils étaient Vietnamiens?
Answer.
Réponse.
Because there were some Vietnamese people living there.
Car il y avait des Vietnamiens qui vivaient là.
And they were brought away, and they were Vietnamese because they spoke with the accent.
Emmenés, et je sais qu'ils étaient Vietnamiens car ils parlaient avec un accent.
Question. Did you know anyone amongst those who were arrested and walked away?
Des gens parmi ces personnes qui ont été arrêtées et emmenées?
Answer, no, I
non.
Don't.
Réponse, non.
Because they belong to a different battalion.
Car ils intégraient un bataillon différent du mien.
I did not even know all the soldiers in
Je
my battalion.
Je ne connaissais même pas
battalion.
Tous les soldats de mon bataillon.
Question. A while ago, you stated that there were Vietnamese living in your village.
Au moment, vous avez dit qu'il y avait des Vietnamiens qui vivaient
and
dans
that you knew them because they spoke with an accent.
Et que vous saviez car ils parlaient avec un accent.
To your recollection, how many Vietnamese people living in your village?
Combien de personnes vivaient dans votre village?
And
réponse.
There were only Chinese in my
bataillon.
There were some Vietnamese in battalion number 2.
Il y avait quelques Vietnamiens dans le bataillon numéro 2.
There were about 3 or 4 Vietnamese families in battalion number 2.
Étaient dans le bataillon numéro 2.
Question. You talk about 3 or 4 families. And can you tell the chamber
familles.
How many people were actually in those 3 or 4 families?
Combien de personnes formaient ces 3 ou 4 familles? à combien de personnes cela correspondait?
Answer, I do not know how many members
Je
there were
pas
in each
combien
family.
De personnes il y avait dans chaque famille.
However, I saw them being tied up and
Mais
walked
j'ai
away.
Vu qu'on les avait attachés et qu'on les a emmenés.
How did you know that there were three or four Ajun families in battalion number 2?
Comment saviez-vous qu'il y avait trois ou quatre familles vietnamiennes dans le bataillon numéro 2?
Answer.
Réponse.
Because these three or four family members
Car ces trois ou quatre
arrested and
ont été
away.
Arrêtés et ont été emmenés.
And that's what I saw.
C'est ce que j'ai vu.
Questioned when Question. Those people were being walked towards the west direction.
Lorsque
did you follow them?
Ces personnes vers l'ouest, les
did you try
suivi?
To see where they were heading to?
Avez-vous cherché à voir où ils allaient?
Answer: No, I did not dare to go
non,
there and look
pas
at
osé
them
y aller
immediately.
Et les voir.
What I saw was they were being walked
Ce que j'ai
to
vu,
the west direction,
c'est que l'on
and
les
later
emmenait vers
on,
l'ouest.
Those who made the arrest returned
Et
without those people
qui
who were
les
arrested.
Arrêtés sont revenus
and
seuls.
Later on, I saw
Sans
the skeleton remains
Et
at
plus tard,
Tour Ta Trang,
j'ai vu les restes humains
the
à Tour
killing
Ta Trang,
site.
Qui était le site d'exécution.
Question.
And
when did you actually go to Tour Ta Trang to see the skeleton remains? How much time had passed between the time that you saw them being walked away and the time that you saw the skeleton remains?
Et le jour où vous avez vu ces restes humains?
Answer.
Réponse.
I saw the skeleton remains
ces
at Tour Ta Trang.
Je les ai vus à Tour Ta Trang.
Question. Witness,
Monsieur le témoin,
I want to know how much time had passed.
Je veux savoir
you mentioned
temps
that
écoulé.
You saw people arrested and sent toward that direction, and later on you said you saw skeleton remains at the Tour Ta Trang, the Koi Mountain. What was the passage of time between the time that you saw the arrest and the time that you saw the skeleton remains?
L'arrestation et les restes humains.
Answer.
Réponse.
It was about 2 days after.
C'était 2 jours plus tard, environ.
When I walked past the area, I saw
Quand
the skeleton remains
moment,
and the flesh had been eaten by
wolves. Les restes humains et des loups.
Question.
Avaient
So, 2 days after, you walked past Tour Ta Trang and you saw the skeleton remains. Can you
bon,
tell
question.
The chamber a little bit
Donc,
more? What did you actually
écoulé,
see and what was
humains,
the condition of the skeleton remains?
Qu'avez-vous vu? Et pouvez-vous nous dire dans quel état ces restes...
Answer. It was likely that those people were hit and killed.
Il était sans doute Ils ont sans doute été frappés et tués.
Question.
When
you were at Tour Ta Trang, how many corpses did you see?
Combien de corps avez-vous vu à Tour Ta Trang?
Answer.
Réponse.
There were 4.
4.
Question, what was the condition of the dead bodies
quel état
or corpses?
Ces corps?
Answer,
Réponse.
The corpses were swollen and being decomposed.
Et en état de décomposition.
Questioned.
question.
Can you tell us about those corpses? What they meant, women or children?
Et pouvez-vous nous dire s'ils c'était des hommes, des femmes, des enfants?
Answer: they were corpses of adults.
C'était des
I could say
adultes.
They were corpses of husbands and wives.
C'était des corps de mari et d'épouse.
Question. Read the extract of your WRI when you were interviewed in your village.
D'audition.
I refer to document E3/51-87 with Khmer 001979-16, English 002741-78, and English and French 002741-85. When you were interviewed, you said,
vous avez été entendu
I
par les enquêteurs, vous
peeped
avez dit,
at the location where they killed those people and I saw the dead bodies of women and children
j'ai vu des cadavres
bearing
de femmes
marks
et d'enfants
of having been
dont la tête
hit on the head with the end of a roof beam. And there
de
were blood everywhere.
De manches de
binette. The skulls of the children
partout.
Were broken, like their heads had been swung into tree trunks.
Si
after that string of June was killed, I never saw
après
any more June remaining.
De, où les, des June ont été tués, je n'ai plus vu de June.
Witness, you said there were dead bodies of women
Monsieur
and children.
Donc, vous avez dit qu'il y avait des corps de
and
femmes et
that
d'enfants.
The heads of their children. Were
et que la tête,
seems to be
des enfants,
broken as they
semblait avoir été
could have been swung against a tree
comme s'ils avaient été
what can you say about your statement?
Donc, que pouvez-vous nous dire au sujet de cette déclaration?
Answer, they were réponse. Arrested and killed
ils ont été
at
arrêtés et tués
I
à Dota
did not witness the killing
je n'ai pas
but
été
I
témoin
saw,
de l'exécution
dead bodies
mais j'ai vu des cadavres
it was possible that the body had been swung against the tree trunk
possible que l'on ait
there were many dead bodies
des corps contre des troncs d'arbres
the area
il y avait beaucoup de cadavres
but I did not see all the executions, I only saw the
je n'ai pas vu
bodies.
Les exécutions, je n'ai vu que les cadavres.
Question. Did you just say that you witnessed some executions and not all executions?
De dire que vous avez vu certaines exécutions
yes,
et pas toutes les exécutions?
Can you tell us a little bit more? Did you actually witness any execution?
D'une
if
exécution?
So, can you give us a bit more detail?
Nous donner plus de détails.
Answer.
Réponse.
I only saw the arrest of the four
je n'ai vu
people.
Que les
however, I did not
personnes.
See the killing.
Je n'ai pas
and
vu l'acte
I only saw the skeleton remains
je n'ai vu
there.
Que les ossements.
At Tultatrong. That's where they were killed.
C'est là qu'ils ont été tués.
Question. Also, in the extract that I just read
question.
Out, you
aussi
said there was
donner,
blood everywhere.
Du sang partout.
My question to you is that how much blood was it?
Y avait-il
and where was it? Was it near the body?
Beaucoup de sang. Où était ce sang? Était-il près
answer.
Des camps?
I saw blood stained on the ground.
De sang sur le sol.
That could be the blood stained, blood remained from being bitten to death.
C'était peut-être du sang qui avait été coulé.
I only saw it and then I fled the area.
J'ai été témoin de cela et je me suis enfui.
Question.
Question.
After you witnessed the arrest and later you saw
après
dead bodies at
l'arrestation et ensuite vous avez vu des restes des cadavres
did
à tout le
you see any other Vietnamese in your village
avez-vous
or in your
revu
battalion?
Des Vietnamiens dans votre village ou dans votre bataillon
President, witness, please hold on, and Councillor Copper, you have the floor.
Monsieur le témoin, veuillez attendre.
Thank you, Mr. President. In my translation, I heard the witness say skeleton remains.
J'entends le témoin dire des ossements.
Question back, in the English translation is from the prosecution, dead bodies.
Et ensuite, on parle de cadavres du côté de l'accusation.
I mean, technically, a skeleton originates from a dead body, but corpse is dead body, skeleton remains is something different. It is important because it takes a while for a skeleton remain to become a skeleton remain. It needs to be decomposing first.
And
in light of the time that the witness said passed between him seeing the arrest and subsequently seeing the skeleton remains, he obviously didn't see decomposed bodies. So, I don't know, it might be an English translation issue, but I think
c'est peut-être un problème d'interprétation, mais à mon avis, il y a une différence entre des dépouilles, des cadavres, des ossements.
Monique Newman,
National Deputy Co-Prosecutor. I am actually trying to clarify with the witness regarding the dead bodies.
Sur cette question.
He said he saw four dead bodies.
Il a vu quatre cadavres.
And allow me to clarify it again. Witness, you said that you were at Tultatram and you saw four dead bodies. And could you please clarify again what was the condition of the dead bodies?
Dans quel état étaient ces cadavres?
And, sir,
réponse.
In fact, some dead bodies dried up after the killing.
Restes étaient desséchés, avaient séché après l'exécution.
Besides these dried up dead bodies,
et à part ces cadavres
did you
desséchés,
see any other dead bodies and that you
d'autres?
Could identify their gender, for example, the dead bodies of women and young children?
Ou de jeunes enfants?
And so actually,
réponse.
The bed smell was so strong that I did not dare to approach closer.
Je n'ai pas osé m'approcher.
Question. After you witnessed
question.
People being arrested and walked away, and then later on
après
you saw the
l'arrestation et
decomposed
de gens,
bodies,
que ces gens étaient emmenés, ensuite vous avez vu des corps en décomposition.
Did you notice that if there were any other Vietnamese in your village or in battalion number 2?
Encore des Vietnamiens dans votre village ou au bataillon numéro 2? Réponse.
No. There was no longer any remaining Vietnamese since they all had been arrested.
Ils avaient tous été arrêtés.
Question. Were you ever explained by your commander-chief or by
votre commandant?
Any upper echelon, the reason for the arrest of the Vietnamese in your area?
Motif de l'arrestation des Vietnamiens dans votre région.
And I did not know the reasons for the arrest.
Réponse, je ne connaissais pas les motifs.
I only saw Vietnamese people arrested.
J'ai simplement vu que l'on avait arrêté les Vietnamiens.
And nobody told me any reasons.
Il m'en a pas donné les raisons.
And of course, I did not dare ask them any question about that.
Et je n'ai pas osé leur poser des
I
questions
was
à ce sujet.
Of my own life.
Je pensais à ma propre vie.
Question. Didn't your battalion commander?
Question.
Tell you the reason why he asked you if there were any Vietnamese in your unit. And why Vietnamese in battalion number 2 had been arrested?
Dit pour quoi les Vietnamiens ont été arrêtés et s'il y avait des Vietnamiens dans votre unité?
Answer, no, I never asked.
Non, je n'ai jamais posé la question. Reasons. Je n'ai pas demandé quels étaient les motifs.
How could I dare
comment
to ask
oserais-je
reasons?
Demander des motifs?
They killed people without mercy,
ils
so how
les gens
could
sans
I possibly ask for reasons?
Comment pensez-vous que je pourrais demander quels sont les motifs de quoi que ce soit?
Questioned.
Question.
You said people were killed merciless.
Vous dites qu'ils tuaient sans pitié.
Who are you referring to?
À qui faites-vous référence?
Answer. That group was réponse. Merciless.
Ce groupe, il était sans pitié.
They used us every day and night.
Ils se sont servis de nous jour et nuit.
Thank you, Mr. President. I conclude my portion and I'd like to hand the floor to my colleague.
Monsieur le témoin. Merci, Monsieur le Président. J'en ai terminé pour ma partie de l'interrogatoire. J'aimerais laisser la parole à mon confrère.
Merci. Bon après-midi, Monsieur le Président, Madame, Messieurs les juges.
Good afternoon.
Toutes les parties.
Your Honours.
Monsieur le témoin, mon nom est Vincent De Wilde. Je vais poursuivre avec certaines questions.
Judge,
tout d'abord sur le sujet de ces arrestations,
sir,
exécution des Vietnamiens.
J'ai
quelques questions supplémentaires à vous poser. Vous avez dit que dans votre bataillon, il n'y avait que des Chinois, il n'y avait pas de Vietnamiens.
Chinese.
C'est ce que vous aviez dit à votre chef.
No,
qu'est-il arrivé aux Chinois? Est-ce qu'eux-mêmes ont été arrêtés ou bien, au contraire des Vietnamiens, ils ne l'ont pas été?
And is it true that the Vietnamese were not arrested?
No, there was no arrest of the Chinese.
Ils n'ont pas arrêté les Chinois.
Chinese were used.
Oh, c'est servi des Chinois.
Of course, they did not have food to eat.
Et il arrivait qu'ils n'aient pas de nourriture.
Bien, je voudrais revenir alors aux chiffres que vous avez donnés.
Very well. Let us look at the figures.
Au début, tout à l'heure, vous avez dit qu'il y avait beaucoup de Vietnamiens dans le bataillon 2. Par la suite, vous avez précisé qu'il y avait 3 ou 4 familles de Vietnamiens. Est-il possible que dans le total de personnes, dans ces 3 ou 4 familles, pouvait s'élever à 20 personnes?
May have been 20 people in all the 3 or 4 families.
There were less than 20 members in those 3 or 4 families.
Il y avait moins de 20 membres dans ces 3 ou 4 familles.
There could be 3 or 4 members in each family.
Peut-être 3 ou 4 membres par famille.
Donc, si j'ai bien compris, vous avez vu deux Vietnamiens être arrêtés.
You
vous les avez vus vous-même.
Arrested. You saw them.
Mais vous nous dites qu'il y avait probablement plus de 10 Vietnamiens dans le bataillon 2, si je compte 3 ou 4 familles et 3 ou 4 personnes par famille. Qu'est-il donc arrivé aux autres Vietnamiens, ceux que vous n'avez pas vus être arrêtés ou emmenés?
That is the Vietnamese you didn't see being arrested and led away.
Since I did not see it, I did not know what happened to
comme
them.
Je ne l'ai pas vu, je ne sais pas ce qui leur est arrivé.
I can only tell you what I saw.
Je ne peux vous parler que de ce que j'ai vu.
Mais vous avez dit tout à l'heure que vous ne les aviez plus revus dans le bataillon 2. Est-ce que quelqu'un dans votre village, dans le bataillon, les autorités vous ont dit ce qui était arrivé au Vietnam?
To the Vietnamese.
No.
No.
Je voudrais revenir alors aux quatre corps
like
que vous avez vus dans la forêt,
Atul
Tathrong.
Atul Tathrong.
À quelle distance étiez-vous des corps quand vous les avez vus?
How far were you from the bodies when you saw them?
I was about 10 meters.
J'étais environ 10 mètres.
Away.
Est-ce que vous êtes sûr d'avoir vu tous les corps qui se trouvaient à cet
Are
endroit
you sure you saw
ou bien
the bodies
étiez-vous
at
trop loin?
Location, or you were too far to have seen all of them?
I could only see what I had described.
Je ne puis voir que ce que je vous ai décrit.
Vous avez vu deux personnes être arrêtées et emmenées dans cette direction.
Two persons being
et puis vous avez vu quatre corps.
In that direction, and then you saw four bodies.
Est-ce que ces quatre corps étaient toujours revêtus de vêtements?
Did you see any clothes on those four bodies?
There was no longer any clothing on those dead bodies since the bodies were being decomposed.
Car les corps étaient en décomposition.
Est-ce que vous avez reconnu, est-ce que vous avez pu les reconnaître étant donné l'état de décomposition des corps? Est-ce que vous avez pu identifier le fait que c'était bien les corps des Vietnamiens qui avaient été emmenés?
The persons who had been led away were indeed Vietnamese.
Not they.
No.
No.
Because I had a look from a rather distance.
J'ai
In fact, I happened
distance.
To be there when I tended the water buffaloes.
En fait, j'y étais quand je m'occupais des buffles.
Tout à l'heure, on vous a demandé si vous avez vu identifier des corps d'enfants. Vous aviez déclaré au juge d'instruction que vous aviez vu des corps d'enfants dont les crânes étaient fracassés. Je vous repose la question de savoir si, oui ou non, vous avez vu des corps d'enfants à cet endroit, dans
Atul Tathrong.
The dog ate some of the bone.
Les chiens ont mangé certains des os.
And there were quite a number of dead bodies, and the smell was very strong, so I did not stand there and examine individually.
Était très forte. Je ne suis pas resté là pour les observer individuellement.
Juste pour essayer de clarifier encore une fois, vous avez tout à l'heure parlé de beaucoup de cadavres. Là maintenant, vous dites un grand nombre de cadavres. Est-ce que pour vous, quatre? Le chiffre 4 est un grand nombre ou un petit nombre?
A great number or a small number of bodies?
I saw some skulls there and some skeleton remains.
J'ai vu des ossements.
And for corpses who had recently been killed,
et
had
les
were
corps
swollen.
Qui avaient été tués récemment étaient, eux, gonflés.
Donc, si je comprends bien, vous
so
avez vu d'une part
well,
des ossements
you saw on the one hand
et des crânes, et d'autre part
skulls,
des cadavres
hand,
en décomposition qui étaient gonflés.
Swollen,
Est-ce que je comprends bien qu'il y avait deux,
so, must I understand that there were
deux
two
cadavres
kinds of bodies on site?
Man.
Answer. You are right. I also saw bones and scalps.
Des ossements.
Scalps.
Et des crânes. Aussi.
D'accord. Alors pour essayer encore de préciser combien de cadavres étaient gonflés
how many bodies were swollen
et combien de crânes
how many skulls
avez-vous
were
vu avec des ossements.
With bones.
Donc les deux catégories de cadavres
so,
que vous avez vus, combien
two
y en avait-il dans chaque catégorie. Donc
so
d'abord ceux qui étaient gonflés
in each category, among
et ceux
the bodies that were swollen,
qui étaient déjà secs.
Among the bodies that were already dry.
Answer. I did not count
je ne les ai pas comptés.
How many bones and skulls were actually there.
Je n'ai pas compté combien de
crânes, I saw decomposed body and after looking at them for a while, I walked
et après
away.
Avoir jeté un coup d'œil pendant un certain moment, je me suis éloigné.
Donc quand vous avez parlé du
so
chiffre 4, c'était, si je comprends bien, les 4 cadavres en décomposition.
The four bodies that were decomposing.
Answer, yes.
Oui.
That of four bodies had been recently
les
smashed.
Les quatre corps avaient été exécutés récemment, écrasés.
And as for
récemment.
The skulls,
alors que les crânes,
they perhaps those people, the skulls remained from those people who were killed
peut-être à des gens
a few days ago.
Qui avaient été tués plusieurs jours auparavant.
D'accord, et donc nous avons bien compris
fine.
Que
so
ces crânes, vous ne les avez pas
comptés. You did not count the skulls, therefore.
Une dernière question
a
sur les Vietnamiens, les autorités de
people,
votre bataillon,
the authorities in your battalion,
de la commune, du district,
or the district,
ont-elles jamais qualifié les Vietnamiens d'ennemis du régime?
Call the Vietnamese
est-ce qu'on vous a parlé du fait que les Vietnamiens
did
étaient des ennemis?
They speak to you about the fact that the Vietnamese were enemies.
Answer. They did not say this to me. I was asked whether or not there were Vietnamese within my unit. I replied that there were only Chinese, and after hearing this, he walked away.
Bien. Avant la pause, je voudrais commencer
Before the break,
alors,
I would like
parler d'un
to
autre
start
sujet.
Speaking about another topic,
c'est celui du barrage de Camping Pui.
The Camping Pui Dam.
Vous avez en fait parlé de la construction de ce barrage aux enquêteurs et d'instruction. Est-ce que vous pourriez nous parler très brièvement de l'importance de la taille de ce barrage de Camping Pui, juste pour nous donner une idée.
So that we can have at least a basic idea.
Answer. The base of their dam was about 100 meters long and the crest of the dam was about 70 meters long.
Mesurait 70 mètres environ.
Est-ce qu'il y avait des digues?
Dikes?
Est-ce que l'étendue des travaux était comprise sur plusieurs kilomètres ou plusieurs centaines de mètres?
Construction covers several kilometers or several hundreds of meters.
Le président.
President, please hold on, Mr. Witness, and you may proceed, counsel, for the Kielsen Pond.
Maître Guissé.
Thank you, Mr. President.
Merci, Monsieur le Président. J'attendais de voir la deuxième question de M.
le
co-procureur pour savoir où il allait en venir. Je crois comprendre de ces questions qu'il entend parler du barrage de Camping Pui qui, a priori, ne se trouve pas dans le champ du procès 02/2. Donc, j'objecte à cette ligne de questionnement si M. le co-procureur entend poursuivre.
If the co-prosecutor indeed intends to continue with these questions.
M. Monsieur le Président.
Mr. President, answer the co-prosecutor.
Je voudrais répondre. En fait, c'est juste une question introductive. Ce qui nous intéresse, c'est de savoir qui a visité ce barrage, et notamment le client de ma consoeur ici présente.
Donc, je ne vais pas insister outre mesure
sur la réalisation du barrage, mais plutôt simplement avoir une ou deux questions introductives et puis me concentrer sur les éventuelles visites de dirigeants ou de délégations étrangères.
Oui, Monsieur le Président,
si
ce barrage n'est pas dans le champ du procès, je ne vois pas en quoi l'éventuelle visite de dirigeants serait également dans le champ. Donc, je demande simplement qu'on s'intéresse à ce qui concerne le champ du procès.
Us to only focus on the scope of the case.
Monsieur le Président, il s'agit du rôle de l'accusé, de sa présence sur le terrain.
We're speaking here about the role of the accused,
c'est un exemple
about his
parmi d'autres de barrages qu'il aurait pu visiter, comme celui d'ailleurs de Trapintma ou d'autres. Il s'agit d'établir le rôle de l'accusé dans ce cas-là.
So the point is here to establish the role of the accused person. Of course, these questions therefore will be part of the scope of this trial.
President, the objection by the defense counsel for Mr. Kusumpong to the last question put by the deputy international co-prosecutor to this witness is overruled. The question is related to the policy and role of the accused. However, I instruct the deputy international co-prosecutor to limit specific questions only to Bang Kamping Pui, since it is not within the scope of the closing order.
De l'ordonnance de clôture.
Merci, Monsieur le
Thank
Président.
You, Mr. President.
Juste une autre question à ce propos-là. Est-ce que ce barrage de Kamping Pui était-il aussi connu ou appelé barrage du 17 janvier?
Also known as the 17 January Dam.
I am not aware of that, whether or not it was also known at the 17 January Dam.
Est-ce qu'il n'y avait qu'un seul barrage dans cet endroit à Kamping Pui?
That place, Kamping Pui?
Answer, yes.
Oui.
There was only one dam.
Il n'y avait qu'un barrage.
Est-ce que des dirigeants Khmer Rouge ou des délégations étrangères sont-ils venus visiter le site de construction du barrage de Kamping Pui? En avez-vous connaissance?
Are you aware of that?
I do not have idea about the visits of
the senior people or the upper echelon. President, thank you. It is now break time. The chamber will take a short break from now until 3 p.m. Court officer, please assist the witness during the break time in the waiting room and please invite him back into the witness stands in the courtroom at 3 p.m. The court is now in recess.